Hello everyone, this is Channin for Waffle Flower Crafts. In today's video, we're going to create a very dimensional card using the Little Fairies Stamp Set. To start today's project, I already went ahead and stamped several images from the Little Fairies Stamp Set in VersaFine Onyx Black Ink, a waterproof ink, onto Bristol paper. I'm now going to watercolor these images in with distress inks. I have a palette on the right. It's just actually a piece of plastic that my scoreboard came in, and I smushed my first distress ink color down, which is antique linen. I'm going to use this for the skin, and then I sprayed some water on my palette as well. I'll take a small amount of water, just a tiny bit, just a couple drops, and get that ink a little bit more liquidy, a little bit more runny, and then I can start coloring in my images. This is actually just the first layer for the skin on these fairies. I will actually go back in later once this has dried with some more antique linen just to add a little bit of shadow here and there to really create the illusion of roundness on her arms, legs, and face. Now I'm moving on to this little fairy's dress. I have two distress ink colors here, Shaded Lilac and Blueprint Sketch, and I did kind of an ombre look on her dress, started with the Shaded Lilac and then did a little bit of Blueprint Sketch at the top to kind of intensify that blue and make it a little darker. Now I'm moving on to their hair. I have two browns picked out, Vintage Photo and Grounded Espresso. The Vintage Photo is a lighter color, so I painted the whole hair with that first, and then to add the shadow, I used this darker ink, the Ground Espresso, to kind of create again that illusion or that ombre look that kind of creates roundness. I typically like to use two shades of distress ink to do that kind of ombre or shaded look. I find it easier, but for other areas that I want it very light, like the skin, I'll just kind of layer up the ink to build up some of that intensity to make it a little bit darker for the shadow. For the wings, I just used a little bit of tumbled glass because they will be covered with glitter later to make them really sparkly and shiny. And now I'm working on this second fairy's dress. For her dress, I actually mixed two ink colors together to kind of create a peach color. And that was just worn lipstick and spiced marmalade. Now I'm adding that shadow again, like I mentioned before, just a little bit more of that antique linen to the skin on these fairies, just to add a little bit of darkness and again create that illusion of roundness. Now I'm coloring in this fairy's little berries and her little leaf on her headband, and I am done with those fairies. Now I'm moving on to the butterfly. So I started with mustard seed and painted the top of the wings. Then I moved to pick raspberry for the middle section, and then I'm kind of going over the two colors a little bit, mixing them to create kind of an ombre look, and then I'm finishing up right by the base of the butterfly with shaded lilac again and some more of that blueprint sketches to intensify the color. Now moving on to my flower. So I painted the center already with the mustard seed. Now I'm coloring the petals with worn lipstick, creating a little gradation on them, and then adding a little bit of spice marmalade to just kind of again create an illusion of roundness on that center of the flower. Now I'm going to finish up the butterfly with black soot, just coloring in the body and just those openings in the wings. Now I'm moving on to the fountain or bird bath. I'm coloring it in with weathered wood, a nice gray. Here I'm going to color the whole thing with that weathered, just a single layer of the weathered wood, and then I'm going back in with some more of the same color, the same distress ink, that weathered wood. A little bit less water added this time, so it's a little bit more intense, and I'm just adding my shadows, adding them to the side of the fountain and then to the little kind of like detailed or like carved openings on the front. Now I'm going to create a gradation with blue here, starting with Mermaid Lagoon. I just kind of did a light color with that, then I did a little bit more Mermaid Lagoon to the edge, less water so more intense, and then I'm going to finish up with a little bit of Blueprint Sketch, again that really dark kind of blue, and this creates a really fun, really pretty ombre on the surface of that, the water in the fountain. Now the leaves are very simple, a twisted citron first and then some mowed lawn, and again creating that little ombre, and that completes my leaves. All I have left to do is that teeny tiny little butterfly here. I'm using the exact same colors that I used for the larger butterfly. Of course, this is teeny tiny, so it's just taking a small amount of ink. I started with the mustard seed, then picked raspberry, and then a tiny bit of the shaded lilac and blueprint sketch. And once I finished coloring that, all my watercoloring is done on these images, and they're actually pretty much dry already because I use very little water when I add it to the distress ink. So I'm going to move on now to constructing my little dome or terrarium for my little fairy scene. So I used two dies here from the Nested Domes die set. Die cut them together out of white cardstock to create this domed frame. I then used the same two dies and die cut them twice out of craft foam to make a craft foam frame. Now I'm going to adhere these two craft foam frames together. This is going to create a lot of dimension. And after I've adhered the two craft foam frames together, I'm then going to adhere the cardstock frame directly on top. I left the insides of those frames in there just to keep everything in that perfect dome shape. Once I'm done, I'll pull the negative out later. Now I'm going to create a grass. This is the chunky grass die. This creates a strip of grass. I actually want a much larger piece of grass, so I'm going to do some partial die cutting here. So I've got some white cardstock, and I'm going to layer the top panel for my die cutting machine just short of the edge of the die, and that will allow me to only cut the grass blades but leave the bottom completely open. So now I have this big area of grass. I'm now going to ink blend on this grass to make it nice and green, starting with Twisted Citron. Just going to ink blend the very top, and once I've covered about a little bit over halfway, then I'll move on to my darker green, which is Mowed Lawn. This is actually much more a larger of an area than I need, so I'll trim this down later, but I just want to get this green on here first, and then I will trim down this strip of grass for just what I need to go behind the fairies or in my little scene. So now that I'm done ink blending the grass, I'm going to move on to my dome here. Now this is just the cardstock dome that was left over when I die cut the dome frame, and now I'm ink blending three distress ink colors, starting with Spice Marmalade, then I moved on to Picked Raspberry, and then I'll finish up with Mermaid Lagoon. Again, these are lots of the same colors that we used to watercolor our images in. That's part of the reason why I love to watercolor with distress inks, because you typically ink blend with distress inks and it just keeps all the colors really consistent in your card making, and everything just is very coherent that way, and it's just so easy to do when you stick with the same materials. So now I'm moving on to trimming down this grass here. So I have the die that I used, the smallest die that I used to create my frame with the domes, and I'm just going to center my grass on there, run it through my die cutting machine, and now I have a perfect piece of grass to fit inside my little scene. So I'm getting very close to the point where I can finally assemble everything for my car, but before I do that, I need to stamp my sentiment. So I just grabbed the birthday wishes sentiment from the Little Fairies Stamp Set, inked it up in VersaFine, and stamped it on the background, my ink blended background. Now I've added double foam tape to the butterfly, the big butterfly, and the fairy, one of the fairies, and I've added single foam tape to everything else. It's the grass, the fountain, the leaves, everything except the little teeny tiny fairy. I also used the diamond texture die and die cut an A2 panel of white cardstock with it to add this beautiful stitched background. I'm gluing now this stitched panel to an A2 top folding card base made from 110-pound white cardstock. That little stitched panel is just going to add a nice little detail, nothing that's going to take too much away from our main attraction, which is our little domed scene. So I added glue to the back side of our craft foam frame topped with our cardstock, and now I'm just going to pull out the center and with some tweezers and leave that alone in place on the front of the card. Now I'm going to add some liquid glue to the backside of our ink blended negative, pop that inside our frame, and now I can start moving on to really assembling the scene. Starting with the grass, removed the backing on the foam tape on that. Now I'm adding my flowers and some of my leaves, my fountain, of course, all these elements have just one layer of foam tape on them, but they are basically two because they're on top of the grass, that which also has a layer of foam tape. So this card definitely has lots of dimension. Now I'm going to add my seated fairy here. She also only has one layer of foam tape, so she just goes right on the flower. Now the butterfly has two layers, as well as this flying fairy, so they are right on the background there. And then I'm going to finish up with my teeny tiny little fairy there, just popping that straight down in the background. No dimension on her. She's just really that's just a tiny little fairy, or a tiny little butterfly. Now I'm going to finish up, of course, with some sparkle. So I added some clear sequins, and now I'm going to add some glitter to both of the fairy's wings, and that completes my card. I'll hold up the camera so you can see all the details. There's definitely a lot of dimension on this card. I usually don't make cards with so much dimension, but it is lots of fun. It really builds a very interesting scene. I hope you guys enjoyed today's card and video. If you want any more info on the products I use, please visit Waffle Flower, and you can follow us on YouTube, Instagram, and Facebook for more creative ideas. Thanks for watching. Have a wonderful day.